Unit 15 Polymers. Copolymerization has been used by nature in polypeptides, which may contain as many as 20 different amino acids. Chemists are still far behind. Do you think that daily life would have been easier and colorful without the discovery of and varied applications of polymers? The use of polymers in the manufacture of plastic buckets, cups and saucers, children's toys, packaging bags, synthetic clothing materials, automobile tires, gears and seals, electrical insulating materials and machine parts has completely revolutionized the daily life as well as the industrial scenario. Indeed, the polymers are the backbone of four major industries, viz. Plastics, elastomers, fibers and paints and varnishes. The word polymer is coined from Greek word poly means many and mer means unit or part. The term polymer is defined very large molecules having high molecular mass. These are also referred as macromolecules, which are formed by joining repeating structural units on a large scale. The repeating structural units are derived from some simple and reactive molecules known as monomers and are linked to each other by covalent bonds. The process of formation of polymers from respective monomers is called polymerization. Classification of polymers. There are several ways of classification of polymers based on some special considerations. One of the common classification of polymers is based on source from which polymer is derived. Under this type of classification, there are three subcategories. Natural polymers. These polymers are found in plants and animals. Examples are proteins, cellulose, starch, some resins and rubbers. Semi-synthetic polymers. Cellulose derivatives as cellulose acetate and cellulose nitrate, etc. are the usual example of this category. Synthetic polymers. A variety of synthetic polymers as plastic, synthetic fibers, nylon 66 and synthetic rubbers, Puna S, are example of man-made polymers. Extensively used in daily life as well as in industry. Polymers can also be classified on the basis of their structure, molecular forces or modes of polymerization. Types of polymerization reactions. There are two broad types of polymerization reactions, that is the addition of chain growth polymerization and condensation or step growth polymerization. Addition polymerization or chain polymerization. Addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization. In this type of polymerization, the molecules of the same monomer or different monomer are together on a large scale to form a polymer. The monomer used are unsaturated compounds, example alkenes, alkydes and their derivatives. This mode of polymerization leads to an increase in chain length, and chain growth can take place through the formation of either free radicals or ionic species. However, the free radical governed addition or chain growth polymerization is the most common mode. Free radical mechanism. A variety of alkenes or dienes and their derivatives are polymerized in the presence of free radical generating initiator catalyst like benzoyl peroxide, acetyl peroxide, tert-butyl peroxide, etc. For example, the polymerization of ethene to polyethene consists of heating or exposing to light a mixture of ethene with a small amount of benzoyl peroxide initiator. The process starts with the addition of phenyl free radical formed by the peroxide to the ethene double bond, thus generating a new and larger free radical. This step is called chain initiating step. As this radical reacts with another molecule of ethene, another bigger size radical is formed. The repetition of this sequence with new and bigger radicals carries the reaction forward, and steps is termed as chain propagating step. Ultimately, at some stage, the product radical thus formed reacts with another radical to form the polymerized product. This step is called chain terminating step. The sequence of steps involved in the formation of polyethene are depicted as follows. Chain terminating step. For termination of long chain, these three radicals can combine in different ways to form polyethene. One mode of termination of chain is shown under. The addition polymers formed by polymerization of a single monomeric species are known as homopolymers. For example, polyethylene discussed above in the homopolymer. The polymers made by addition of polymerization from two different monomers are called copolymers. Buna S, which is formed by polymerization of 1,3-butadiene and styrene in example of copolymer formed by addition polymerization. Polythenes are linear or slightly branched long chain molecules. These are capable of repeatedly softening on heating and hardening on cooling and are thus thermoplastic polymers. There are two types of polythene as given below. Low density polythene, it is obtained by the polymerization of ethene under high pressure of 1000 to 2000 atmospheres at a temperature of 350 Kelvin to 570 Kelvin. In the presence of traces of dioxygen or epoxide initiator, the low density polythene is obtained through the free radical addition and hydrogen atom abstraction. It has highly branched structures. The polymers have straight chain structure with some branches as shown. Low density polythene is chemically inert and tough but flexible and poor conductor of electricity. Hence it is used in insulation of electricity carrying wires and manufacture of high squeeze bottles, toys and flexible pipes. High density polythene, it is formed when addition polymerization of ethene takes place in the hydrocarbon solvent in the presence of a catalyst such as triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride at a temperature of 333 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin and under a pressure of 6 to 7 atmospheres. High density polythene thus produced consists of linear molecules as shown below. Another high density due to close packing. Such polymers are also called linear polymers. High density polymers are also chemically inert and more tough and hard. It is used for manufacturing buckets, dustbin bottles, etc. Polytetrafluoroethene. Teflon is manufactured by heating tetrafluoroethene with a free radical or persulfate catalyst at high pressure. It is chemically inert and resistant to attack by corrosive reagents. It is used in making seals and gaskets and also used for non-stick surface coated utensils. Polyacryl nitrile. The addition of polymerization of acrylonitrile in presence of peroxide catalyst leads to formation of polyacrylonitrile. Polyacrylonitrile is used as a substitute for wool in making commercial fibers as Orion or acrylene. Condensation polymerization or strip growth polymerization. This type of polymerization generally involves a repetitive condensation reaction between two bifunctional or trifunctional monomeric units. These polycondensation reactions may result in the loss of simple molecules as water, alcohol, hydrogen, chloride, etc. and lead to formation of high molecular masses condensation polymers. In these reactions, the product of each step in gain a bifunctional species and the sequence of condensation goes on. Since each step species produces distinct functionalized species and is independent of each other, this process is also called step growth polymerization. The formation of terylene or dacron by the interaction with ethylene glycol or terephthalic acid is an example of this type of polymerization. Polyamides. These polymers possessing amide linkages are important examples of synthetic fibers and are termed as nylons. The general method of preparation consists of the condensation polymerization of diamines with dicarboxylic acid or condensation of amino acids to their lactams. Nylon 6,6 is prepared by the condensation of polymerization of hexamethylene diamine with adipic acid under high pressure and at high temperature. Nylon 6,6 is fiber forming solid. It possesses high tensile strength. This characteristic can be attributed to the strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding. These strong forces also lead to close packing of chains and thus impart crystalline nature. Thus, nylon 6,6 is used in making sheets, bristles for brushes and in textile industry. Nylon 6, it is obtained by heating caprolactam with water at a high temperature. Polyesters. These are polycondensation products of dicarboxylic acid and diols. Dacron or terylene is best known example of polyesters. It is manufactured by heating a mixture of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid at 420 to 460 Kelvin in the presence of zinc acetate, antimony trioxide catalyst as per the reaction given earlier. Dacron fiber, terylene is crease resistant and is used in blending with cotton and wool fibers, and also a glass reinforcing materials with safety helmets. Phenol formaldehyde polymer, Bakelite and related polymers. Phenol formaldehyde polymers are the oldest synthetic polymers. These are obtained by the condensation reaction of phenol with formaldehyde in the presence of either an acid or a base catalyst. The reaction starts with the initial formation of O and para hydroxymethyl phenol derivatives, which further react with phenol to form compounds having ring joined to each other through CH2 group. The initial product can be a linear product, Novolac, used in plants. Novolac, on heating with formaldehyde, undergoes linking to form infusible solid mass called Bakelite. It is a thermosetting polymer which cannot be reused or remolded. The Bakelite is formed by cross-linking of linear chains of the polymer Novolac. Bakelite is used for making combs, phonograph, records, electrical switches, and handles of various utensils. Melamine formaldehyde polymer. Melamine formaldehyde polymer is formed by condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. It is used in manufacture of unbreakable crockery. Copolymerization is a polymerization reaction in which mixture of more than one monomeric species is allowed to polymerize and form a copolymer. The copolymer can be made not only by chain growth polymerization, but by step growth polymerization also. It contains multiple units of each monomer used in the same polymeric chain. For example, a mixture of 1,3-butadiene and styrene can form a copolymer. Copolymers have properties quite different from homopolymers. For example, butadiene styrene copolymer is quite of tough and is good substitute for natural rubber. It is used for manufacture of tires or floor ties, footwear components, cable insulation, etc. Rubber is a natural polymer and possesses elastic properties, and it is also termed as elastomeric polymer. In elastomeric polymers, the polymer chains are held together by the weak intermolecular forces. These weak binding forces permit the polymer to be stretched. A few crosslinks are introduced in between the chains, which help the polymer to retract to its original position after the force is released. Rubber has a variety of uses. It is manufactured from rubber latex, which is a colloidal dispersion of rubber in water. This latex is obtained from the rubber tree, which is found in India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Malaysia, and South America. Natural rubber may be considered as a linear polymer of isoprene 2-methyl-11-3-butadiene, and it is also called a cis-1,4-polyisoprene. The cis-polyisoprene molecule consists of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interactions and a coiled structure, thus it can be stretched like a spring and exhibits elastic properties. Vulcanization of rubber. Natural rubber becomes soft at high temperature and brittle at low temperature and shows higher water absorption capacity. It is soluble, non-polar solvent, and is non-resistant to attack by oxidizing agents. To improve upon these physical properties, a process of vulcanization is carried out. This process consists of heating a mixture of rubber with sulfur and appropriate additive at a temperature range between 373 Kelvin to 415 Kelvin. On vulcanization, sulfur forms cross links at the reactive sites or double bonds, and thus rubber gets stiffened. In the manufacture of tire rubber, 5% of sulfur is used as a cross linking agent. The probable structure of vulcanized rubber molecules are depicted. Synthetic rubbers are any vulcanized rubber like polymer which is capable of getting stretched twice its length, however, returns to its original shape and size as soon as the external stretching force is released. Thus, synthetic rubber are either homopolymers of 1,3-butadiene derivatives or copolymers of 1,3-butadiene or its derivatives with another unsaturated monomer. Prepare of synthetic rubbers, neoprene or polychloroprene, is formed by the free radical polymerization of chloroprene. It has superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oils. It is used for manufacturing conveyor belts, baskets, and hoses. Buna N. You have already heard about Buna S. Buna N is obtained by the copolymerization of 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile in the presence of peroxide catalyst. It is resistant to the action of petrol, lubricating oil, and organic solvents. It is used in making oil seals, tank lining, etc. Molecular mass of polymers. Polymer properties are closely related to their molecular mass, size, and structure. The growth of the polymer chain during their synthesis is dependent upon the availability of the monomers in the reaction mixture. Thus, polymer sample contains chains of varying lengths, and hence its molecular mass is always expressed as an average. The molecular mass of polymers can be determined by chemical and physical methods. Biodegradable polymers. A large number of polymers are quite resistant to environmental degradation process and are thus responsible for accumulation of polymeric solid waste materials. These solid waste cause acute environmental problems and remain undegraded for a quite long time. In view of the general awareness and concern for the problems created by polymeric solid waste, certain new biodegradable synthetic polymers have been designed and developed. These polymers contain functional groups similar to the functional group present in biopolymers. Aliphatic polyesters are one of the important classes of biodegradable polymers. Some examples are polybeta-hydroxybutyrate, co-beta-hydroxyvalerate. It is obtained by copolymerization of 3-hydroxybutanoic acid and 3-hydroxypentanoic acid. PHBV is used in specialty packaging, orthopedic devices, and controlled release of drugs. PHBV undergoes bacterial degradation in the environment. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an alternating polyamide copolymer of glycine and amino caproic acid, and is biodegradable. Polymers of commercial importance. Besides these, some other commercial important polymers are listed below. Summary. Polymers are defined as high molecular mass micromolecules which consist of repeating structure units from corresponding monomers. These polymers may be natural or synthetic origin and are classified in number of ways. In the presence of an organic peroxide initiator, the alkenes and their derivatives undergo addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization through a free radical mechanism. Polyethene, Teflon, Aldol, etc. are formed by addition polymerization of an appropriate alkene or its derivative. Condensation polymerization reactions are shown by the interactions of bi- or polyfunctional monomers containing NH2OH and COOH groups. This type of copolymerization proceeds through the elimination of certain simple molecules as H2O, CH3OH, etc. Formaldehyde reacts with phenol and melamine to form the corresponding condensation polymer products. The condensation polymerization progresses through step by step and is also called step growth polymerization. Nylon, Bakelite, Dacron are some of the important examples of condensation polymers. However, a mixture of unsaturated monomers exhibits copolymerization and forms a copolymer containing multiple units of each monomer. Natural rubber is a cis-1,4 polyisoprene and can be made tough by process of vulcanization with sulfur. Synthetic rubber are usually obtained by copolymerization of alkene and 1,3-butadiene derivatives. In the view of potential environmental hazards of synthetic polymer waste, certain biodegradable polymers such as PHBV and nylon 2 and nylon 6 are developed as alternatives.